Management and Decisional System, State Estimation. In this video, we'll present the basics of state estimation functionality, which becomes a necessity in the modern smart grids. At the end of the video, you will understand the necessity for voltage control in modern distribution grids, understand the importance of state estimation implementation, know the basic framework of the state estimation algorithm. Power networks are, in general, divided in terms of their function and voltage level. High voltage transmission networks deliver power from the generation sites to distribution substations. From there, the power is distributed to the end customers by the means of distribution networks of medium and low voltage levels. The smart grid solutions are mostly focused on the distribution networks. So let's take a closer look at them. Distribution networks of the past were passive, with power flowing from the substation to the end customers. Only a few measurements were available in real time. There was no need for any advanced control schemes. Modern distribution networks additionally involve increasing number of highly stochastic prosumers of higher nominal powers, such as heat pumps and electric vehicles, renewable distributed generation, and energy storage systems of various technologies and with different operating modes. Additional level of control must be introduced to this kind of network by the means of switching equipment. For the operator to accept proper operating strategies, new meters must be introduced to the network in order to establish its observability. And, in the end, communication pathways must be established between the elements of the system. It allows data acquisition and remote equipment control in real time. This is the outline of smart distribution networks of the future. The distribution system operator must make sure that the supply voltage characteristics for its customers are within permissible bounds, defined by the legislation. Assume that we have a feeder connected to the sources. This feeder supplies four loads. Each section of the feeder has some impedance. Electrical impedance is a characteristic quantity of an electrical component, such as network distribution lines. It is the measure of the opposition that a material presents to a current when a voltage is applied. The easier the current passes through the material, the lower its impedance. This impedance causes voltage deviation along the feeder. The deviation depends on the current, which depends on the load. Assuming each load consumes the power, then the voltage amplitude profile would drop along the feeder, with the lowest voltage at the furthest point. With decreased loading, the voltage drop along the feeder is lower. In modern networks, the introduction of distributed generators causes voltage profile to rise. In some cases, without sufficient controllability, this could cause some voltages to be over the permissible level. Modern loads of higher nominal powers, for example, EVs and heat pumps, can, on the other hand, cause the supply voltage to drop below the permissible levels. Sufficient amount of reliable measurements from the grid, which allow the operator to know the current state of the network, is a prerequisite for any network control. To make it possible, extensive measuring equipment and reliable communication paths are installed in the smart grids. Communication infrastructure and the consumers aside, the remainder of the system represent the power network itself, which is controlled by the operator and the meters taking the measurements. The first can be characterized as topology, whilst the second as measurements. As mentioned before, operators in control centers are responsible for network operation based on the received data of topology and measurements of the electrical variables. Unfortunately, raw data usually has some flaws caused by asynchronous measurement acquisition. Measurements on different locations are acquired at different time instances. Meter failures. Meter hardware or software errors occur from time to time. Insufficient number of meters. Some locations of the network are not covered with designated meters due to economic or technical reasons. And communication errors. Communication paths fail due to congestions or equipment failure. These issues prevent the straightforward usage of measurement data for the purpose of the network control. Introduction of the state estimation algorithm to the system can cope with the presented issues. Its purpose is to determine the current state of the network, usually through the estimation of voltage amplitude and angles in every network bus. Estimation is based on the model of the network topology and acquired redundant measurements. Measurements consist of real measurements, which are actual measurements from the meters in the network, acquired in real time, virtual measurements, which are measurements on the buses without any load. If there is no load, then loading in this bus can be fixed to zero in advance. Pseudo measurements, that are estimates based on historical data and advanced algorithm. These are calculated for the locations where there is no meter present or the existing meter is in an error state. The second input for the estimator is topology. Topology for the state estimation process is being defined by the underlying algorithm, based on the network data, such as impedances of lines and information about existing connections between different buses. The network can be reconfigured through switching manipulation. Therefore, also the location and status of the switches is important. The third part is the state estimation process itself. It consists of a number of underlying functionalities which can be summarized to the following groups. Through observability analysis algorithm checks, whether there are enough measurements available to estimate the network, and if not, load estimation functionality provides additional pseudo measurements to render the system observable. Then the system is being estimated by the means of chosen state estimation algorithm, and in the end, the results are being analyzed for the presence of errors. Possible errors are being neutralized in the estimation process. In the end, the estimated state of the network is the output of the state estimation process by the means of defined state variables. As mentioned before, the vast majority of state estimators utilize voltage amplitudes and angles as their state variables. Nevertheless, it could also be variables of other types, such as current or power. After the estimation process is done, the voltage at each bus of the network is thus defined. To conclude, state estimation functionality determines most probable state of the network, based on the network model and acquired set of redundant measurements. In the case of sufficient redundancy, the estimator can correct erroneous measurements and supplement the missing ones with generated pseudo-measurements. Thanks for watching.